The sarcophagus we are examining is one depicting the mythological story of the Gemini twins, Castor and Pollux, also known as the Diosauri, which means sons of Zeus. They are stealing the daughters of King Leucippus.
The scene depicts them stealing the daughters in a spectacle of confusion and taking advantage of the situation. Starting from the center, you see a woman with two men on either side, Castor and Pollux, both dragging women away from the center.
The women they are pulling away are the daughters of the king, two women the twins desired to marry. You will notice that the twins look identical, most likely to depict that they are twins to the uninformed admirer. The daughters that they are pulling apart are also identical, most likely for the same reason that the twins are identical.
Shift the attention to the left. There are two men wielding a sword and shield that appear to be at odds with each other. This is most likely part of the commotion which the twins took advantage of to steal their future betrothed. Beyond the warriors, there's an angelic-looking woman, which in Roman culture was known as a victory, who is holding a serpentine structure.
Shifting attention back towards the center and moving to the right, you will notice a woman and a man to the right of the other twin. They are not in any sort of conflict, such as the two men on the left, but they appear to be taken aback by all of the commotion. They are followed by another victory, mirroring the one on the left.
On either side of the sarcophagus, there's a mirror image of a twin riding away on a chariot, each taking one of the two daughters. When you look at the design on the top, there's a symmetrical scene depicting two victories sacrificing a bull on either side of some sort of ritual object. The scene is depicted three times.
At each corner, there is the head of a satyr. A satyr is the mythological creature that was comprised of half man and half goat. Both satyr heads are identical in design, location, and facial features. Both are an elder man with long hair and a beard.
There are many angles from which the work of art can be viewed, since there is relief sculpture on all sides of the sarcophagus. The work appears smooth and shiny. The surface of the marble has withstood the test of time.
This could be because it was most likely stored in a tomb and was not exposed to the elements that have been so perilous to so many works of art. A sarcophagus from this time would have been made from marble, because that material was easy to find in 2nd century Rome, and it was a common medium for many different sculptures, reliefs, and buildings.
Marble is also a durable material that would preserve the deceased as well as the glory of the art depicted. That way, the person would have their status acknowledged for the years to come. Although the work here isn't symmetrical, there's an asymmetrical balance to it.
The center of the relief sculpture on the front of the sarcophagus is skewed slightly to the left. The center figure has five figures on either side of her, but to the left they are more closely bunched together. The elaborate design on the sides of the sarcophagus would be meant to show the status of the deceased.
The sculpture was an incredible work of art that caught both our eyes as soon as we entered the room. If you look closely, you can also see... John Cena!